Greetings, fellow Oldlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with the scenario independent quick missions. The next mission at hand is Mission Playbook, which takes place in the Middle East during the evening hours, 18:40, 6:40 in the evening. The skies are, as always, clear. Usually, the missions take place under clear skies for the most part, from what I've seen. I don't know whether that's a feature of just like the choice of level design, whether it would have been easier, or whether it was actually just a choice of level design, or whether it would have been difficult for, well, the game to handle it. I honestly don't know, but yeah, that is clear skies is what we usually get. Very rarely overcast, or I don't think I've ever seen rainy weather. I have seen foggy weather though, and that sucks, to be honest. Anyhow, aerial intelligence has discovered a major enemy communication center. Infiltrate the center, recover the enemy's codebook, and destroy the communication center. Okay, so this seems like a rather difficult mission.
An RC-135 surveillance aircraft has identified an enemy communications post. Command believes a raid on this outpost will uncover some much-needed intelligence. Proceed to Objective Siren and retrieve the enemy codebook. Alpha and Bravo teams will insert northeast of the objective and will have to bypass an enemy checkpoint. Once Alpha and Bravo teams have breached the perimeter, Charlie will insert by parachute directly on the objective. Bravo will locate the codebook and place satchel charges in the comm center, while Alpha and Charlie teams serve as security. Once the comm center has been destroyed, all teams will rendezvous with Black Widow for extraction.
Now, full disclosure, I've actually played this mission before while I was essentially testing what is best, testing the best, resolution and everything for this game. And this mission does actually have a helicopter. Now, I don't know whether it's going to shoot at us or not, but I think carrying a law would be the appropriate choice in this case. And I honestly don't know where to place these satchel charges. I've never completed this mission per se. Anyhow, let's begin this time around and hope that our experience playing this game will prove useful.
This is Black Widow. All King elements are in the LZ.
Roger, Black Widow. Break. Bravo. This is King 6. There's a checkpoint along the road between you and the objective.
Bravo is spotted. He's compromised.
And the game is at the lag.
Guys, moving up the main road.
Right at the beginning. Sort of did me dirty right there. Sort of. Spread sort of, it did me dirty right there.
South 1. Bravo has eyes on checkpoint. Looks like only a couple bad guys.
Roger that. Proceed with caution.
Now, the previous time around, I was being extra cautious and trying to recover the codebook, but it did not work out. I sort of died while attempting the recovery, and here we are. Nothing there. Okay, moving on to the actual enemy base itself. Like, you really need to clear out the camp before you head in and try to obtain the codebook, because otherwise the enemies are gonna spot you and they're gonna kill you. So yeah, caution. Caution is the name of the game. Now, there are some bad guys here that I would like to shoot out. It says 400 meters, I would rather take ones out that are closer, but apparently it's a little difficult from this range. Sometimes I feel like that guy's dead. Somebody was shooting at me from on the hill there. That guy's also dead. All immediate threats have been taken care of. There should be like a couple of bad guys behind this hill here. Or rather behind this feature of the terrain. Oh, Alpha actually took care of one of them this time around. Took care of both of them this time around. My god, Alpha. Look at you. You've become so good. But the thing is, as soon as we enter the Comstar we will be surrounded by enemies on all sides, which is something that we typically want to avoid, a scenario that we want to avoid. We don't want to engage the enemy on their turf. That's one guy dead. And for the other guy to be dead as well. Good thing it takes only one shot to kill enemies in this game. And I do believe I can reach every coffee like this. Yes, I could. That is all I really wanted. And this guy is conveniently hidden away behind the dam. Steel bar there. Don't know where that truck is going, but yeah, it's inconsequential. I don't think that truck has anything. Thought I saw an enemy there, so I took a shot and there was an enemy there. Another enemy. I do believe? Yes it is. It was another enemy. Now there are some more folks here that require a healthy dose of shooting. And it's our job to give them that. I'm just taking out all the windows so it's easier for me to see where the enemies are. Sometimes they're running all over the place. There are enemies in there, we just need to be a little cautious with our approach. I'm just gonna wait for that guy to come over again. Dead. You just have to time it right. And you're done. You're set. Oh, come on. Come back. Let me see you. I need to kill you. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Don't know where you went again. I was sort of looking at another point when I suddenly saw him come back. That was sort of my bad over there. Okay, that's another guy there. Dead. There's some folks inside of these buildings as well. And here's the thing, no matter whether we take these stairs or whether we, you know, go through this part here, there will be enemies around the back that we need to get rid of first. Which is pretty much the issue. So here's a new proposal. Instead of going right in for the kill, we circle around the place. Circle around the place, take out all the enemies from all the sides, and then we head in for the kill. I feel like that's a far better strategy than just heading in for the kill outright, like these guys here. We would not have seen them if we had not taken this angle. I think that's just some sort of a machine. We don't really need to bother ourselves with that, but what we need to bother ourselves with is the lag. And yeah, thank you. Of course, it's a double boost of lag. Thank you. No matter how powerful your graphics card or machine is, this game will lag on it, and it's just a problem with the processing of the game. The way this game processes instructions, it causes it to lag. Nothing that you can really do about it, except for just bear with it. I wonder if that's an enemy in there. No, that was just a crate, not an enemy. Yep. Some folks started shooting at us, like the one right there. Should be more folks, should be at least another guy in there. But I'm yet to see where the enemies are. As soon as I do, I'll be shooting them. Dead to rights. That's what they'll be. Dead to goddamn rights. Nothing there. I was just trying to see if there's anything in there, probing for information. Turns out there isn't any. There was a guy back there, but I won't waste my time with him. I'll get him from another angle. Just scanning the environment for potential threats. I don't see any. Moving on. If somebody starts shooting at me, I'm just gonna leave prone and forget any of this ever happened. The codebook, I scanned the bottom for the codebook. There's the codebook there. The codebook is most definitely upstairs. I'm just trying to figure out who was shooting at me from behind, because as soon as I came here and tried to enter the place, I got shot from this angle and I died. Maybe it would not be such a bad idea to target spooks that we see from here. There should be a guy in there. I can't see him. Maybe he's already dead. I don't recall killing him though, but chances are low that he's already dead, but I'm still looking anyway. Ah, I see you. Were you the one who shot and killed me? Could be, actually. Could very well be. Saw a guy there. I'm not gonna waste my time with him. There are better ways to target him from afar. The problem with this game is sometimes it just decides to spawn enemies. When you get near the objective, enemies won't be there at the beginning, but as soon as you get near the objective, they'll suddenly be there. And yeah, that's just one of the problems with this game. Another enemy there. Shot out. Is there an enemy there then? Can't see anybody, to be honest. I'll just leave them be. Don't see anybody in here either. Would be amazing to just clear them out with a couple of grenades, but I don't exactly want to waste them. I was wondering what that is. Nothing of value. Nothing of significance. It was most likely that guy. One of these two guys that shot me dead. The last time I was trying to clear this mess. Is that an enemy then? Well, I think that's just a broken pile of rubbish. I think clearing the camp out from three angles should be good enough to guarantee our safety. To an extent. Somebody else was shooting at us, it was with a handgun. There's still a guy back here. He like comes and goes. Yeah, got him. So there was a guy back there, no longer is. Charlie 1 and 2 have begun their assault on the camp. Okay, now where are they getting shot from? That side? Huh, interesting.
Bravo, King 6, Charlie team is down.
They both got shot and killed. That is sad, but well, it has to happen one way or the other. The codebook is definitely upstairs, but we'll check downstairs nonetheless. Sometimes the codebook might be there. Downstairs, I mean. Is that an enemy? No, that's a dead enemy. The best kind there is. Sometimes I feel like I speak in slogans, you know? Dead enemies, the best that there are. I see enemies there. Maybe I might try to shoot them. One guy's down. That's Charlie 1 over there. Okay, time to check these quarters and then finally make an assault on the base itself. I think the base is cleared out for the most part now. I don't think there are any more soldiers in there, but does not hurt to be cautious nonetheless. Okay. Moving into the base. Reloading. Really? Okay, somebody is shooting at us. I would like to know who it is. I really would love to know. Sound came from somewhere over here. I can't really see where the enemy is though. Which is the major cause of concern. I have no idea why my gun disappeared, but breaching this fence here. Tossing grenade inside. That also works. That's another way of getting rid of any fences. Something else broke in there. Pretty sure it was not. An enemy.
6, this is Alpha 1. We're at the objective and engaging the enemy.
Okay, there's somebody in here. Probably somebody left over in here. Somebody that we forgot to take out. Hey, this is the code, it wasn't here the last time around. Okay, it tells me to place a charge here, so I'll just drop a charge here, and yeah. Maybe the guy's upstairs, because I can't see anybody here. Oh, I see something. Yeah, sort of forgot about that guy there. Codebook secured. Let's hope things stay as smooth throughout the game. Clearing the angles, the corners. Maybe just a dead enemy. Sounds like the guy's above me. And... the guy is above me. Reloading again. Tossing a grenade in there. Just to clear it out. You know, so that it does not continue to be an issue later on. Somebody definitely in there. Since the code book is secured, I'll just go ahead and pop in a few grenades there. Since I have cleared this side out, I think I'll just stick to this here side for my assault. Since there is no more shooting, I think this area has been sufficiently cleared. And I think we place another charge here. And what do we do now? Codebook has been secured. Heading downstairs. Moving to a safe distance before I blow up the charge. All of this has already been cleared. Keeping a watch on my backside. Moving near Alpha 1 and 2 for the cover that they can provide, and now we're gonna blow up the charges. Let's hope that is sufficient to finish the mission. I see a tree there. Alright, not impact back, we need a detonator.
King 6, Alpha 1, we've eliminated the target.
Roger that. All King elements proceed to rendezvous with Black Widow.
Now, okay, Alpha 1 and 2 are, I think, leading the way, so I think I'll just follow them. Because, well, they will, if there are enemies, they will warn me of it by, well, dying first, so. Yay! Unless the enemy just decides to shoot me, and goddamn, these health charges are powerful. Yeah, I thought that there would be some enemies there. Blowing up whatever I can blow up for no reason whatsoever. Okay, we're back on track. This was a difficult mission, I'm not gonna lie. For a quick mission, this was a pretty difficult mission, and I was primarily impressed by how. Shot through the shin. I hope there are no enemies that come our way from here. Waiting for the frames to return, which they did. Okay. This is gonna be difficult, this is gonna be slippery. The thing is, I sort of knew that there were going to be enemies here. Charlie team was supposed to take care of them, but they did not. So. But since we have successfully extracted, I guess I'll just stand here. I'll wait here, yeah. King 6 is Bravo 1. The codebook has been acquired. Alpha and Charlie teams have been RKIA. Returning to base, over and out. As soon as Black Widow lands, that is. And that was it for Mission Playbook. I mean, for a quick mission, it was rather difficult. The mission structure, it felt more like a campaign mission than a quick mission, because the rest of the quick missions have been pretty simple, straightforward, easy, so to speak. But this one not only had multiple objectives, but even the level design was quite difficult. Initially, I was mostly testing on this level because, yay, you get a parachute in, which is like a new addition to this game. You don't really have that in Delta Force, the original Delta Force, but only in Delta Force 1. However, it still is pretty, well, how do I put it? A little difficult, to be honest. And yeah. Anyhow, that was it for Mission Playbook. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be covering Mission Deception, which apparently is actually a convoy assault mission. I like this screenshot, it has like a really strong Dutch tilt to it. Or maybe it doesn't, because the camp is straight, these vehicles are just tanked. But then again, the mountains in the background are also tanked, so I'm guessing this camp is just askew. Strange. Anyhow, when we come back, we will be covering Mission Deception. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.